You don't have to have revenue, but you got to have traction. And the traction is either somebody who's touched your prototype or your minimum viable product. You don't have to be GA or generally available. Just you have to have something that somebody who's going to pay you.
This video is brought to you by Procopia Law, the recommended law firm of Founders Floor.
In multi-channel or multi-tiered markets, you can't show it to just one person in the chain, because if they're not the one that writes the check. So for example, let's say if you have a consumer product. You can't tell us that Best Buy loves it. Now, if Best Buy loves it, that's a good thing. But that still doesn't tell us if it won't sit on the shelves at Best Buy. You better have some metrics that say that the end user is going to like it. Or if you're selling through Hewlett Packard, who's going to be your channel partner to sell to enterprise companies to sell networking equipment, having Hewlett Packard say they love it, that's a great thing. But guess what? They're not writing the check. Make sure that you have end users validate what you're doing. That's kind of the state of the industry in the venture, in the Series A, Series B. You've got to get, you got traction. And if it's a consumer play, you need metrics. I say that over and over and over, because a lot of deals are consumer deals. Now there are some VCs, and we do this sometimes, but it's rare, where we think it's such a fantastic idea, we'll bet on it before you get feedback. But almost anything you see out there that's funded, they probably had some metrics. They had their website up for a month and they show you the weekly numbers. Instrument your product to the hilt if you're in the consumer space, and give us metrics sliced every possible way you can do it, because we want to know that. Because how do we extrapolate? If you don't know anything, most people know that consumers are pretty fickle. It's pretty hard to figure out what they're going to like without seeing if they like it.